Hello, and welcome to my new sort of maker setup. Except for the first time in this setup, we are actually doing a declutter. Whew, I have a lot of lip products. And I've never really wanted to declutter them because it's like, just have them lying around. I can use them whenever I want. But this giant bag is completely filled with lip products. Actually, it's filled with other makeup too, but clearly I don't wear it. I really want to use this for perfume. If you don't know, I've been doing some perfume reviews on my channel and I would love to organize them. So we're gonna clear this out. We're also gonna clear this out and this out and a couple other things. Ooh, I just spied some things that I missed. So I've got a whole bunch. I'm gonna try and make this fast. Gonna take a little second and organize everything into categories. If you're interested, I will list the categories down below. So if you have a favorite lip gloss, liquid lipstick, lip balm, more therapeutic stuff, I will try and make that clear. I personally find declutter is kind of fun because I like seeing what people keep and I like seeing people's impressions of products that they've obviously used a whole bunch. So there's some things that I have here that I think will be very indicative of how I feel about them. Some stuff there's no way I'm gonna let go of, and some stuff I can't wait to get rid of. So I think it'll be fun. I'm looking forward to clearing all this out. I also have a whole bunch of Ipsy bags and stuff that I'm maybe thinking about organizing stuff in. I don't know. We'll see how it goes. I clearly need to have stuff a little more accessible so I use it more often. Okay, we're gonna go down below and get organized. Okay, here we are. We're gonna gather everything into little piles that are hopefully nicely organized, and I'm gonna go into speedy epi time to do that. Let's go. Okay, hello everyone. We are ready. That took me so long to do. Gosh, I'm overwhelmed. I think I have more of everything than I thought I did. I think that this is a great thing to do. I found things that I totally forgot about, and I'm excited about things that I didn't know I had. So we're gonna start with, I think we're gonna start in order of intensity. So excuse this table, I tried to finish it myself and the stuff wasn't sticking, so I'm gonna try not to wrestle too much. So we're gonna start in order of intensity with lip balms, soft things on your lips. As you can see, I already did a little swatching, but let's grab everything. Okay, so it's interesting. I kind of thought that I had more of these products, but once I gathered them all together, I realized I just had a lot of the same. So we're gonna start with something that I would like to address, and gosh, I'm gonna have to remind myself that I'm gonna try to be quick. But this is the Laneige Sleeping Lip Mask, lip sleeping mask, whatever. This is the mint, chocolate mint one. I had it in vanilla as well, and I got the chocolate mint because that's kind of my favorite sort of flavor. I'm not impressed, and I really, really hate digging my finger into this every night and then rubbing it on my lips, and then my finger's all gunky and I'm like, I kind of rub it on my arm. And it's just, I don't enjoy this. I don't like using my fingers and I don't think it's that great. Like, it comes off really quickly. So I'm not repurchasing this. I'm gonna finish this one, but I'm not repurchasing it. Let's gather all of these lip balms together. Some of them you may have watched me open in lip monthly boxes. They're all the same, really. This one is actually, I was sourcing a product and I was gonna make some lip balm, and this was the company that I sourced it from. And they're actually fantastic. This is their peppermint lip balm. I've been using this for years now. It's really good. It's just fine. I really enjoy a peppermint lip balm. I have another one of the brand. I think it might be it was eucalyptus mint. So anytime I've gotten other peppermint lip balms, it's like I already have some that I sourced myself. I'm gonna be keeping these because they're just fine. I've had them for a long time. This one I think I got for free at some event or something, so I'm gonna get rid of it. Generic simple lip balms, right? If you're interested, this company that I'm keeping is clearly organic. And I'm gonna grab one of the bags that I have lying around. This one I've had for ages, and just start throwing lip balms in there. These, I only have two of these, but they are the Ulta SPF lip balms. What a super surprise, super fun thing. They are excellent. So they're SPF 30. I hope that they're good because they're really good. They're really enjoyable to wear. This coconut one is my favorite. The flavor is great, rather the smell. And the texture is really enjoyable. Like, it's quite emollient and it stays on well. So these two are my favorites of the sun protection, which is kind of saying quite a lot because I have ones that I thought would be more of a favorite, which I'll go into now. Sunbum. Man, I was obsessed with Sunbum for a bit. You can see this is rolled around in my purse a bunch. I love the aesthetic, the little gorilla dude. It's just so cute. And their flavors were killer. Key lime and banana. Banana was my favorite. And I just thought that they were the bee's knees. They were the best. But they kind of have this like thin texture that I don't feel like sticks to my lips very well. I don't know how to explain it, but it's almost like it goes on more like a lip oil than a lip balm, as opposed to the Ulta ones that are quite emollient and stick to your lips. So these sun bums, I still love the flavor. Oh, just giving them a sniff right now, it smells like summer. So I'm gonna keep these just because I love the flavor, but I prefer the Ulta ones, to be totally honest. This is called Night's Kiss. And so just to clarify here, I probably won't get rid of much by way of lip balms because this is the product that I reapply the most. And my requirement for a lip balm is that it be a balm to my lips. So that's really easy to accomplish. You really just need beeswax and that's it. So this is my least favorite lip balm out of everything that I have here. I know this without a doubt. It's Night's Kiss Lip Balm and it's by Notoriously Morbid. It says it's full moon, cranberry and red velvet cake. I like the applicator. I like that it's rectangular, but there's something about this that is completely non-existent. It's nice and emollient, but there's nothing in it. I don't get the flavor, I don't get the smell. It just doesn't have an enjoyable experience. So Notoriously Morbid, I haven't really loved much of their lip products, unfortunately. This is a lip balm from my sister's company, so I'm definitely keeping that. This lip balm you might have recently seen me open in my Lip Monthly, and now that I think about it, I think I'm missing some Lip Monthly stuff, so I probably have lip stuff lying around. It's a simple strawberry lip balm that's not very strawberry. I'll keep it around because lip balm. This is Little Moon. It's a frosty lip balm. It's nice and minty. I really enjoy the mintiness. It's called Peppermint Shtick by Little Moon. I like the mintiness of this one. I gotta go into this. This is Apocalyptic Beauty. It's called Resurrection Mary. This stuff is amazing. This is absolutely amazing. Can you see the blue color of this? Like, it's hard for me to tell if that's focusing, but it's actually, I hope you can see this. It's like a frosty blue. Can you see that? Oh, you can totally see that. It's a frosty blue, but it's also a moisturizing lip balm. It's absolutely amazing. I wish they had different colors of this. They don't. Oh God, it smells great. It feels great and it looks phenomenal. Like, it looks really cool. So oftentimes I'll do like a fairy pixie sort of frosty look and I'll top my lips with this and I can wear this even when I'm wearing a mask and it's not gonna rub off underneath because I'm just wearing some lip balm, you know? It's just something nice and moisturizing and also looks amazing. Apocalyptic Beauty, somehow, if you're watching this, can you make more shades of this? I'd be so happy. All right, some random stuff. Lip exfoliants. This is just one that I bought from a market. It's called justface.space lip scrub. I really liked how they had the wood and everything, but once again, I don't enjoy things I have to stick my fingers in. And I just find lip scrubs get all over. They just fall all over. I'm not gonna get rid of it, but I don't know, I might. You know this one, the e.l.f. lip scrub. So many people have it. It's really annoying and almost gross to use. I mean, it looks absolutely disgusting. I'm gonna get rid of this one actually, to be totally honest. I'd rather keep around that other one because they both annoy me equally, but this just looks disgusting. I'm gonna toss that. Bouncing around in a weird way. This is not meant to be here. Bouncing around in a weird way. Back to some sun protective stuff. Labello. I used this when I was a kid and I loved it so much. I love that it gives your lips a tiny bit of a white tint. I actually had to order this from Germany. It's a sun protection lip balm. I'm not sure if you can see any white tint. Not really, but I used to wear it to school and it was my sneaky way of wearing makeup. We couldn't wear makeup to school in South Africa at least. But I find that when I wear this, especially for something athletic like biking or working out, ooh, it's cracked. It gives me a bad taste in my mouth. I'm not sure if it's the sunblock or whatever, but it just starts to taste bad. So I use this, but when I'm doing short sports, like if I'm gonna do a 30 minute workout or something outside, then I'll use this and eat something afterwards or have a drink because it doesn't taste great. This I got in something. It's called Boost Color Enhancing Lip Balm. It's just a lip balm. There's some residual stuff. It's just lip balm. Notoriously Morbid. This is a slumber salve. I hope I've been using it correctly. It smells really good and I think it's a lip balm. I'm pretty sure it is. A lip balm that you put on when you sleep. I really don't like it. I keep it because it smells good and lip balm is something I use so often, but I don't like this at all. I like it way less than the Laneige. It's not good. It's not good. It almost feels drying. Since I'm talking about things I don't like, I gotta talk about these two things. Okay, this is the Clinique Black Honey. I didn't purchase this individually. I think I got one of the Sephora like five lip things for 20 bucks, whatever, and this was in it, and it is a phenomenal lip balm. You wouldn't think so looking at it, like it looks like a dark lipstick, but it just gives you a little sheer tint. It's almost like a gloss. Oh, it feels so good. I just had to use some. This is delightful. This is absolutely gorgeous, and I feel like I need a separate bag for this, for stuff that I use or will use often. I almost feel bad using that, but I should just use it. This is Tarte Berry is all that it says. I think I got in the same thing, and I feel like this is the identical formula. As you can see, it sort of does the same thing. It's a little less of a color hint, but it's more pepperminty, and it's so good. Oh my gosh, it's so good. Ah, it's literally like the Black Honey one by Clinique, but it's more pepperminty. I don't know how much this costs. I'm sure it's a lot. I don't think I would have gotten it if it wasn't in that bunch. And the material, the packaging feels cardboard. The design almost looks like it was a Christmas thing because it smells all pepperminty and Christmassy, but it's so good. It feels amazing. Just such a good formula. This was a Notoriously Morbid Slumber Salve, and I just like the packaging more than anything. So I was trying to figure out if I could break the packaging apart and put other stuff in there because like maybe the Laneige would be more enjoyable, but I didn't. I just realized we're probably gonna end up splitting this video into three parts because I don't wanna overwhelm you guys. So I might release it like 3 days in a row. Okay, so my battery died, hopefully nothing changed, but yeah, I just decided I'm gonna do this in three videos just because I can see we're already at like 15 minutes, so hopefully this isn't too terrible. Okay, these are incredible. Ink.redible. I got these in the UK last year and I love the brand Incredible. You're gonna see a couple of their other things. I just think they're so fun. Their stuff tends to be insanely sparkly and it is. Okay, now don't be deterred by how gross this looks. This just crumbled apart. It's like an opalescent, pearlescent pinky inside. And it's almost like our Apocalyptic Beauty lip balm. So it's an opalescent inside and then like a sort of a clear balm on the outside, and it's just lovely. It just it's a lovely hint of shimmer and sheen in a pearly pixie fairy like shade. It's gorgeous. I absolutely love this. There's also a gold one, which is similar, actually really identical, and this is sort of what the other one looked like. You can tell which one I've loved more, but I like having the variety of having a gold look and a cooler toned look. And then there is a clear one that does have glitter in it. It's less exciting looking, but there is glitter on the inside. It's just kind of that somewhat more boring, there was lipstick on it already, but a more boring multicolored glitter like Claire's stuff. This does feel a little juvenile, but I love it. We talked about the Notoriously Morbid. Now this, Shop AOA. This is a Shop AOA honey lip oil. I love this for nighttime. I really love this. Like sometimes I'll mix it and I'll put my Laneige on and then I'll put this on top, but really I prefer this more than anything. It doesn't look like there's much here, but I've been using this for a long time since I did a Shop Rosé order, which was like a very long time ago, like maybe 7 months or something. More actually now I think about it. Anyways, it's really good. It actually feels like an artisanal honey thing, a honey oil. I like, it's weird that this is a dollar. I'm pretty sure it's a dollar, maybe $1.88. So floored by this. I'm definitely gonna order more when I do an order with them, which I think I might do soon. So excellent stuff. I'll be reordering that. This. Because I was going through things, I found this again. And this is so funny. It's Jane Iredale Just Kissed Lip and Cheek Stain in Forever Pink. It's the tiniest little sample that I got in something. I don't know. I mean, look at it. It's teensy weensy. It's absolutely fantastic. It gives my lips sort of a hint of pink berry sort of tint. It's, I don't know. It's quite magical. And it smells delicious, like a candy passion fruit. It's delicious, delightful. I've traveled with this thing a bunch. I use this on the plane. So sometimes, like, back when we could travel, I would like to get the front seat where you can't have your bag so that I could hop out really quickly and get off the plane when we landed. So I would tuck this in my bra along with earplugs and stuff like that. And then I just pop this on during the flight. And it's so teensy weensy, and it's just the best concoction of lovely hydrating lip goodness. It's so good, and I'm so glad I found this again, and I think I'm gonna see about buying a full one if they even make this anymore, because it's been a while. Yay, yippee, that was all about lip balm. Oh, but wait, there's an honorable mention. These items over here. These were back when I ran the company, The Infamous Black Sheep. I still have it. I still have the website, and one day I might do something with it again, but I made lip balms for it, and I just can't ever let them go. They were very white based, so the goal was to sort of have a punch of pastel color and a delicious flavor and be hydrating at the same time. So it was a vegan formula that I actually had made. Absolutely delicious. I love it so much, I can't ever get rid of it. I don't think I would ever use this now, because these are like, okay, don't freak out. These are like 15 years old. No, 10 years old? They're 10 years old. But so that's the mango shade, the strawberry. You can see I've used that one. Chocolate, ooh, I used quite a bit of that one. And black cherry, ooh, I forgot how nice that black cherry was. So I love these. It took me so long to get the formula exactly perfect. I still have it written down, and I can never get rid of them. I just can't get rid of them, and maybe one day I'll make them again. And upgrade them for a new refresh. Anyways, these are almost like antiques. Okay, so that is all the lip balm. Come on by tomorrow, and we are going to go into lip stains, which is a small but mighty section. Thank you so much for watching. Let me know what you thought about the products that I have. I know I'm not really getting rid of anything, but I just feel like lip product is so easy to use, and if it's not bad, then I don't want to get rid of it. And I have some bad stuff coming up. I do. In my liquid lipsticks, a bunch of them have gone bad, but in lip glosses, lip balms, lip stains, it doesn't seem like a lot of stuff goes bad very quickly, and it's just so easy to slather it on and pan it, you know, which is gratifying. Anyways, let me know what you thought about the stuff I have, if you have any opinions. Maybe you hate some of the things I have. Anyways, wherever you are, I hope you're having the best day that you possibly can. Be kind to the people around you, and thanks for hanging out.